And we're here at the 14th hole of Spring Hollow, the signature hole. Built in 1994 during the boom of golf design. Let's take a look at this course built by John Tomlinson.
And with a Google rating of 4.3 and 460 reviews, we were excited to sit back, relax, and enjoy this facility that's family run and operated and has a little bit of history about the foundation of the course.
There's a good amount of elevation at this course, 110 feet to be exact, most of it on the back nine. The course is family run and operated, and it's got some history, at least in the last 30 years. It's always been a public golf course. It used to sit on a farm. We're going to talk about the history of the farm here. But more importantly, these family run golf courses, they're the ones we're trying to go out and play. It really has some charm to it, and we're excited to see all the elevation of almost 110 feet of elevation on this course. And regards to the driving range, there's none here, so make sure you take advantage of the practice facility.
Built on an old dairy farm, and it blends the feature of the farm and the surrounding area. Stretching over 6,000 yards and a par 70, this course has two different practice facilities, at least to make up for the driving range. I don't think you really need the driving range. You can always add simulators inside. I didn't take a look. This is located in Chester County. The golf designer, John Tomlinson, has built a few other courses in the King of Prussia area. Pickering Valley, just to name the one that's closest to it. Stretching at 6,018 yards, I recommend playing from those back tees. The hardest hole at this course is number 7. It's 412 yards. It's par 4. Overall, my experience here was pretty high. I like anything that used to be an old farm, being an old dairy farm. It still has that charm and keeps that charm in the clubhouse. Has more elevation than you would suspect, so that's always nice. Most of that elevation is on the back nine, so if you did play a quick nine, try to sneak out into the back. Overall, the course was in pretty good conditions for the price that you'll end up paying. I don't like putting the price because lately it's been so rapid. I think it will stay consistent. I think a $40 to $50 bill to walk the course plus carts and annual fees like that is well worth it in the winter time. That's the time that we're here, so that's arguably the lowest price possible. I think it's well worth that range of price. There's also a military base right next to it, and you could see I was pretty much fascinated by that structure.
I'm curious on what this is. I saw it on Google Map. It's right here. It's got to be some sort of military base.
These family-run facilities, they have that extra charm to it when you have it to yourself. If it's busy, it's hard to like it because sometimes it gets packed up and they're not really meant to take on a resort type feel. But when you have the place to yourself, or maybe just a few groups or locals that you're playing with, it's really enjoyable. And I think this is well worth the trip if you're in Philadelphia, only 30-40 minutes. If you're coming outside Philly and traveling through and haven't played this course, think about sneaking over and playing the old dairy farm that converted over to a golf course in 1994. Now, John has a great layout here. I think some of the tee boxes are smaller than you would suspect. They got a little back-to-back here.
Back-to-back par threes.
I was lucky enough to convince the starter to just let me go out and get some footage of this facility because I was meeting up with another YouTuber later that day.
Tim recommended we got to get some footage of this hole and take a look. It's a long par four that you got to lay up on, and then the second shot uphill over water.
Down my favorite hole, and even when I was chipping and putting, I was gravitating towards this hole. It's a standout hole. You can almost hit it too far, end up in the water. You have to lay up, and then that second shot, it's really enjoyable because you have those bunkers that are sitting behind it, so it does not turn into a punch bowl unless you get really lucky. You will end up stuck in those bunkers with a impossible shot, elevated then to a backdrop of water. It's a challenging hole, and it's easy to make a mistake on that hole. There's few bridges and streams cutting through it. I don't know if it's majority of the time cart path only. It didn't feel like that, so you do have the freedom to kind of enjoy it. The greens, I recommend kind of hitting a little bit before the green and letting it roll up because of the terrain. It is more rocky than you would suspect. The tree line, everything else was more open, kind of a link style feel to it. And some of the holes, it definitely got parkland style. Overall, I enjoyed number 17 and 18, that par 3, ending the round at number 18. The cart was good, everything else was a great experience. Hopefully this video provided a little insight to these family run facilities, and thanks to Tim for letting me get out here, play this course, and hopefully down the road interviewing some of the folks there.